Welcome to the Wally Park studio, delivered by Papa John's. Amanda Busick with Lewis Bloom, and John Kernan joins us for the roundtable, guys. And two races down, we have four to go before we head to St. Louis. So let's start with some of the points lead changes and kick it off with Steve Torrence. John, you caught up with the Capco team in the shop. What's going on?
Well, they are very pleased with the results. They would have liked to have won on Sunday against Brittany Force in the final, but they burned a piston. The pan pressure switch shut off the engine, and that's why Brittany was able to pull away. But they say that now that they've got the lead back, they don't have any plans of relinquishing it again. And as we've seen, that team can get on a roll and go round after round after round, and that's what they plan to do this weekend.
Of course, Brittany Force actually had the same thing happen to her in the semifinals, according to Alan Johnson and Brian Usen. They came up with the big win. It's hard to believe that we have three drivers really within a round going into the third race of the countdown, and looming in fourth is some guy named Antoine Brown. You can never count out the three-time champion, especially at a track like Gateway, where he's won five times in Top Fuel.
John Brown seems to love Gateway Nationals. And guys, as we move over to Funny Car, there's been some issues with Matt Hagan kicking off the countdown. John, you caught up with his crew chief. What's going on there?
Well, after Matt lost in the semifinals when the parachute came out prematurely on Sunday against Ron Capps, he told me that, hey, if we didn't have bad luck, we'd have no luck at all. So I checked in with his crew chief, Dickie Venables, to see how they might change that luck.
We had a really good car in Reading. We made 3 second runs every run we made, even when the run with the chute came out, you know. I don't know if we had won that round, but still, it's demoralizing to see the chute come out, knowing that you at least had a shot at winning. You know, certainly from here on out, I don't think if you lose first round from here on out, I don't think you're going to have a chance, you know. So you need to go rounds. That's what it's all about.
Of course, going rounds is on everyone's mind right now because, Lewis, that is how you stay in the hunt for the countdown to the championship when we get to Pomona to end the season.
Yeah, pretty incredible that Ron Capps took over the points lead. Robert Height's car looks so good at Charlotte, lost second round to Courtney Force. But, you know, the big story is that Ron comes to a racetrack where in 1997 he won his first ever of 56 races in Funny Car. So I like to call that a good karma stat for Ron Capps at Gateway.
And guys, Bo Butner is ahead of the points in Pro Stock again, and his confidence must be at an all-time high, John.
Oh, absolutely. I talked to him, you know, after he won the race on Sunday. Actually, even before that, he was telling me when he retook the points lead after Tanner Gray lost to Greg Anderson, Greg with that perfect light, Bo had that look back, the swagger back. So watch out for them, Lewis.
Absolutely, of course. Greg Anderson now 0-3 in finals at the last three races. I mean, that is just unheard of for Greg Anderson. He's going to be determined to go rounds at Gateway, and we'll see how Tanner Gray responds to that second round loss.
I would imagine if you could start the countdown in any fashion, you would want to win race number one and race number two, and that's exactly what Eddie Krawick has done in Pro Stock Motorcycle. Lewis, is this his championship to lose?
Yeah, pretty much. You know, L.A. Tomlin was in the final round, obviously broke something, I would assume a transmission, but the Screaming Eagle Harley, after they made that chassis chain, the win at Indy, which is huge, first two races of the countdown. John, you know those guys well. When they run fast, they're hard to beat.
Oh, absolutely. And Eddie's doing a great job, you know, at the starting line. And you mentioned they switched back to the old chassis, but with the new bodywork, the new street rod bodywork, they're going to continue to develop that new chassis and hope to have it out here doing what they need it to do, which they couldn't get the finger on how to fix that during the summertime. But we can expect that new chassis, that newly designed chassis, to maybe be back when they kick off the season next year at Gainesville.
Well, one thing I have to talk about is the fact that Scotty Polacek, with the help of Greg Underdahl, qualified number one for the first time. A huge moment for his confidence. He has a really good bike. And by the way, the last time we had a new first-time winner in Pro Stock Motorcycle was at Gateway, Jerry Savoie, 3 years ago. It's been a while.
Well, race number three is on deck as we head to St. Louis. What do you say we pack our bags, guys?
I'm ready.
Okay. For John Kernan, Lewis Bloom, I'm Amanda Busick. Guys, stay right here on NHRA.com for all things drag racing.